Hey, are you ever going to buy me some more Warhammer models so I have someone to actually play Warhammer with?
Of course I will. I just have to save up for a little bit before I can afford them. I mean, give me a year and I should be able to buy one or two. I can 3D print you some. Until then.
No thanks. All that 3D printed stuff breaks way too easily.
You break giants, mechs, dragons.
I work hard and I play hard. So yeah.
Whoa. Okay, well, what if I told you that 3D prints were different now? That they were stronger, better, more resilient?
Bring it on. Let's see what your new models can offer.
I have been receiving a lot of models over the last few months from companies like Warmachine, Malifaux, Infinity, and just being able to look at all of these along with Warhammer miniatures. And it has given me a little bit of a different perspective when it comes to what a miniature should be.
That was a tiny man.
And on top of that, I just got a brand new 3D printer. And so I have been printing, I have been painting, I have been assembling all these miniatures, and it's absolutely insane how quickly my pile of shame is growing right now. But I'm loving every minute of it.
He's completely lost his mind.
While I've been going through this slightly insane journey, I've come up with a few questions that have kind of been nagging me in the back of my mind. And so I thought I would use this video to kind of talk about those. And those questions are 3D models finally to the point where they're on par with the big boys, with, you know, other companies out there that are releasing and selling models? With that being said, are 3D printables affordable enough to be a thing that everyone should have in their hobby repertoire? You know, is it something that everyone should be buying that's in this hobby right now? And lastly, if I was just getting into the hobby now, would I buy a 3D printer? So, are 3D printed models on par with the big boys? The answer to that is yes and no. Okay, you know, they're releasing printers all the time that have better resolution, better, you know, printing, they're faster, they're bigger, you can print more all the time. There's something new that is coming out. But are they able to print on par with plastic, with, you know, with Games Workshop, with Infinity? And the funny thing is I've been looking at these models, and the big difference is, right, is that no matter how thin of a layer you do, resin is always going to print in layers. And if you look at the model at just the right angle, you're probably going to be able to see those layers. So is it going to ever be as clean straight out of the printer? Probably not. You're probably always going to be able to see those layers, even if they were a hundredth of a millimeter. And for some people, that might be an absolute no. That might be a nope, I'm not even going to do it then. But the funny thing is that the second that you put a base coat, a primer on that miniature, they go away. They go away. I mean, there are some special situations where that's not quite the case. You know, like in a flat surface and things like that, you might be able to see it a little bit. But in all honesty, a layer of paint does wonders to make these 3D printed models look exactly the way any other model does. Okay, with sanding and things like that, you can get them to be just about perfect. But is that worth it to you? At the same time, do you have to have something that's absolutely, you know, the same? Or is something that's almost the same good enough? I mean, the quality of these is insane. And the other thing that I have to bring up when I say that is it also depends on the type of resin. I have so many people comment about how, well, you can't kit bash with them. You can't cut them. If they fall, they break. Warmachine has been 3D printing their own models for the last year or so. Okay. And you can tell the difference in the models because every time they get a new formula, the color of the model changes. That's one of their newer models. This is one of their older ones. As you can see, the colors are different. A little darker versus the light gray. I dropped this two or three times while I was trying to assemble it onto hard floor, and nothing broke. Okay, it's bendable. It's not crazy bendable. Okay, it's not on par with like the Wargamer resin from Fauxhammer. Okay, which is just amazing. That stuff is so malleable. It's incredible. Okay. But you can kitbash this stuff. I'm putting together a video right now of a Warmachine model that I am going to be kitbashing. Well, that I've already started the process of kitbashing. And to cut it off, I used clippers and nothing shattered, nothing broke. It was honestly a dream to work with. So my answer to that question is yeah, they are on par with them now. And especially if you get a higher resolution printer. The printer that I just got is actually the Anycubic Photon Mono 4. It is their new entry-level printer that comes out next month. I'll do a review on it later in a different video. It is a 10K resin printer, and it's awesome, and it works great. I pulled it out, set it up, threw in a file, printed it. Awesome. Okay, and we'll talk a little bit more about that in a bit. But 10K resolution is more than you will ever need to meet the standards of other gaming companies. When I put it next to the Warmachine ones, they're almost better. Okay, so yeah, we've gotten there. So have 3D printers gotten to the point where you should have one as a tabletop gamer? Again, this is one of those ones that's, it's a yes and a no. It depends on what you're willing to do for your miniatures. Cost wise, yeah, I mean, this printer that I just got, it's $189 right now on pre-order. And I think it's just a little over $200. It's a phenomenal little printer. And like I said, it's probably all you're ever going to need unless you wanted to print something just enormous. Okay. Cost-wise, yes, it's worth it to get into it. You know, I posted a video a while back about making a Warhammer, a full 2,000-point army for under $500. Okay. And that was with an older 4K printer. I could still do it now for under $500 with this new printer. So if a Warhammer army for $500 is worth it to you, check that video out. It's right here. So you got to decide if the work that goes into 3D printing makes it worth it for you. With water washable resins and things like that, it's honestly easier than it's ever been. You print it, you pull it out, you throw it in a tub of water, pull the supports off, let it dry, cure it. Okay, you don't need the fancy wash and cure stations. You don't need to do all that stuff. Are they nice? Yeah, of course they are. But you don't need them. Okay, did they make the process faster? Sure. Fast enough for me to spend the money on it? Not yet. You know, if anybody wants to send me one, you know, wink, wink, nod, they can. But for the time being, I don't need one. And neither do you. So if that process is worth it for you, then yeah, definitely you should buy this, because it's not just for printing miniatures. It's for printing terrain. It's for printing tufts for the miniatures that you're painting, or skulls or props or kitbashing things. There's a million different things that you could be printing that make this hobby better. You can print your own dice if you want to. Literally thousands of things that you can print that will make your experience better and get you sucked into this hobby, because it's awesome. And lastly, would I buy one now? Knowing what I know now, absolutely. I love painting miniatures. I love it. Okay. But sometimes you want something that's a little different. Are you sick of painting Space Marines? Well, then maybe you should print the Cadaver Carrier, who's literally a giant with bodies strapped to him in a cage of skulls and things off the back. I mean, there is a million things out there that you can print and paint. You know, if you, painting is the part of the hobby you like the most, you've got to get a 3D printer. You've got to. If kitbashing is what you like the most, get a 3D printer. You will not regret it. Okay? If assembling an army and painting and going to tournaments is what you live for, you don't need a 3D printer. You don't need a 3D printer to do any of that. Okay? But if you want to print your own terrain and things like that, go for it. Honestly, right now, printers are in the best spot they've ever been, and they're just getting better. They're just getting easier to use. So go out and get one for $200. Like I said, I'll do a review on this printer a little later, and you can kind of see the ups and downs of it. Great little printer if it's what you're looking into getting. And I'll be putting that out next week. With that being said, what do you think? Are 3D printed models to that par, you know, to that milestone that they need to be to have people wanting them for their games? I mean, one of the things that I love is that there are multiple game companies out there that are saying, yeah, 3D print our models. We'll sell you these files. Here's the rules. You know, everyone talks about how it has to, you know, you can't sell files. You can't sell them or things are going to fall apart. And that's not the case. You know, companies will find a way to make it work. Yes, even Games Workshop can find a way to make it work and probably make more money than they are making now. So, do you think that quality is where it needs to be? Do you think everyone in this hobby should have a 3D printer? And if not, tell me why. Tell me why. I mean, if you think they're not worth buying, I want to know why. Because I think they're amazing. Okay. And lastly, those of you who have been printing for a long time, if you got to start over, would you do it again? I posted a video a couple weeks back about why people give up printing, because I've seen so many people just stop because it gets hard. And so it's obviously not a hobby for everyone. But in my mind, it's so easy. like I don't know why people struggle so much. And I know some people do, and I know it's because of printers and different things, you know, the whatever the issues you've had, there's a way through it. So if you got an issue, let me know in the comments below, and I'll do my best to help you out. Thank you for joining us here at Pulsegate Games, where we are all about playing games like Warmachine, Warhammer, Infinity, but we're also all about 3D printing. Those games are amazing. The quality of those models is incredible. And like I said, the Warmachine models, they're just getting better. Come and check them out. And if you like this content, please like, subscribe, come back. Like I said, I'm going to be posting a review on that printer, but then we got other stuff coming out in the works, kit bashing, printing, all of that fun stuff. So come along for the ride. And as always, don't spend so much time building your world that you forget to spend some time in it. Till next time.